Hi guys, I'm Nancy, and this video is about radians and degrees. I'll tell you what radians are, and I'll show you how to convert from radians to degrees, and how to change back from degrees to radians, so both directions. So what are radians and degrees? Well, they're just different ways of measuring an angle. They have different units for saying how big an angle is. Just what you wanted, I'm sure, another way of measuring an angle. Well, you'll need to know both, radians and degrees. And the way you know the difference is that a degree angle measure will be some number with a little degree symbol up in the corner. A radian angle measure will not have a degree symbol. It could be either just a number, like 20 radians, RAD is the abbreviation. Or more likely, it has a pi in it, like 2 pi over 3 radians. That's usually how you'll know it's a radian angle measure. So what is a radian? Technically, the definition is that if you have a circle with a radius r, and if you traveled an arc length along the outside of the circle that was the same as r, the angle, theta, central angle that creates that length is one radian. So that's the technical definition. So let me show you radians and degrees on a circle. Say you have a circle. As you might already know, one full circle is 360 degrees. So if you start at one point on the circle at 0 degrees and you move counterclockwise around the circle, one full circle all the way back around is 360 degrees because a quarter of the way is 90 degrees, halfway is 180 degrees, three quarters of the way is 270 degrees, and all the way around is 360 degrees. Now, if you're doing this in radians, the angles would be different. They would have pi's in them. You could start from 0 radians, move counterclockwise, and a full circle for radians is 2 pi instead of 360 degrees. So a quarter of the way around is pi over 2. Angle, halfway around is pi. Three quarters of the way around is 3 pi over 2. And all the way around is 2 pi. So this is very important, that 360 degrees is equivalent, so this is the same as 2 pi. 360 degrees equals 2 pi. You're going to use this when you convert from radians to degrees or degrees to radians. But first, you can simplify this, and what people typically do is divide by 2. And actually use as a conversion equation 180 degrees, half a circle, is equal to pi, also half a circle. So when you convert from radians to degrees and degrees to radians, and I'll show you examples, you're going to be using one of two factors. You'll either use pi over 180, pi over 180 degrees, you'll multiply by that conversion factor to get radians. So if you're starting with degrees, you'll multiply by pi over 180 to get to radians. And then if you're starting with radians, you'll multiply by the flipped version, the opposite, 180 degrees over pi, in order to get degrees in your answer. Those are very important. You'll be using those in the conversion problems. So now let me show you examples of how to convert from degrees to radians and radians to degrees. Okay, say you have a problem that says convert 200 degrees into radians. So you're changing from degrees to radians. always start by writing down the first angle measure you're starting with. 200 degrees is your original angle measure, and you want to change it into radians, but always just write down the number they gave you first. 200 degrees. Then, in all of these conversion problems, you're going to multiply by either this factor or this factor, pi over 180 degrees, or 180 degrees over pi, depending on which way you're going. So you're going to have this factor you're multiplying by. How do you know which one? Well, you can memorize these reminders if you want, or you can just remember the trick that whatever type you're starting with, in this case degrees, is also the type you want to put on the bottom so that it cancels. So you want 180 degrees on the bottom so that the degrees will cancel. Now if that's true, you have 180 degrees on the bottom, then your pi has to go on top. So I think that's a really good way of remembering it. Or you can just remember those directions and those conversions. So this means 200 degrees times pi over 180 degrees. It's very simple. Now all you need to do is simplify, if possible. Those degrees basically cancel, and you need to simplify 200 over 180, and you have a pi left over too. So in the next line, this is the same as 200 over 180. And put one number over the other, since this is basically 200 over 1, and we multiply fractions straight across. And then you have a pi over 1, but you can just write pi. Okay, so use what you know about simplifying fractions. 200 over 180 is not in simplest form. A good trick is that if there's a 0 on top and bottom, 0 at the end of the top number and at the end of the bottom number, you can just cancel those. So a simpler fraction is now 20 over 18 pi. But you can go further. Always try dividing by 2 if they're even. 20 dividing by 2 is 10. 18 divided by 2 is 9. And you still have the pi. Don't forget the pi. So this is 10 pi over 9. And that's the simplest fraction next to pi. And you should write, technically, you should write radians as your units. Because even at this point, the pi was your radian. So if the degrees canceled, you're left with radian units. And so your final answer is 10 ninths pi radians. Okay, now say you have a problem that wants you to convert radians into degrees. Like, convert 2 pi over 9 radians into degrees. Okay, same idea. Always start by writing down the number that you're given, 2 pi over 9, the actual number that appears in the problem. So 2 pi over 9. And as you might have already guessed, you're going to multiply by either this or this. Which one it is depends on what you want to get rid of. You have radians right now. So when you choose your factor, your conversion factor, you want the version that has radians or pi's on the bottom. So your pi, which is radians technically, your pi is on the bottom so that your radians cancel. And then the 180 degrees has to be on top. So if you're memorizing these things, if you start with radians and you want degrees, it's this factor, 180 degrees over pi. Okay, so this is your setup. Now you just need to make sure you get it into simplest form. So your radians cancel. Your pi's also cancel because you have 1 pi on top and 1 pi on bottom. That's good because you usually don't have pi's in degree angle measure. So now what you need to simplify is 2 over 9 times 180 degrees. That degree symbol is there, and that's good because you want to end up with degrees. So we can multiply straight across. If you want to write this as 180 over 1, that's fine. And this is 360 degrees, 2 times 180, over 9 times 1. You can simplify this. Since 36 divided by 9 is 4, 360 divided by 9 is 40. So your answer is 40 degrees. The degree symbol is important. All right, here's another problem where you're given a decimal number for the number of radians. For instance, convert 1.5 radians into degrees. All right, this sometimes throws people off that there's a decimal, 1.5 radians, instead of pi radians or 2 pi over 3 radians. You can just have some number of radians, and you still use the same method to convert to degrees. So write down the number that they gave you, 1.5 radians. I know you've seen a few examples now, so you may already have figured out. You want to use the 180 degrees over pi conversion factor. 180 degrees over pi. This pi is in radians, which is good because those radians cancel and the units you're left with are degrees, what you want. Now, I would recommend if you're allowed to use a calculator, if you have a calculator, you can just plug these numbers in at this point. 1.5 times 180 divided by pi. Pi is usually in your calculator. If it's not in your calculator as a button, you can use 3.14 for pi. If you want to do a little more algebra first to get this into simplest form, you could write 3 halves instead of 1.5. And then you're multiplying by 180 degrees over pi. You could simplify this. 180 divided by 2 is 90 degrees over pi. And then you have a 3 here as well. So it's 3 times 90 degrees over pi, which is 270 degrees over pi. This is an exact answer, but usually when you're changing to degrees, you want a number or a decimal. So I would recommend plugging in into your calculator 270 divided by pi, or 270 divided by 3.14, and see what decimal you get. Most of the time, that's the way you want to leave your final answer. And if you do that, you'll get 85.9. Don't forget the degree symbol. That's your number of degrees. You could also, if you don't like using a calculator, you could divide by 3.14 by hand. That's fine, any way you want, but usually you want to leave it in decimal form for degrees with a degree symbol. I hope this video helped you understand how to convert from degrees to radians and radians to degrees. Who knows? Maybe one day you'll be stuck on an island without a calculator. It's okay. You don't have to like math, but you can like my video. So if you did, please click like or subscribe.